It's a Northwest Lifestyle Weekend on Como News. Now back to IRG's Health Talk.
All right, our next guest, Dr. Cynthia Warner, cardiologist from Providence Medical Center, talking about heart health for women. Of course, it's important for both men and women, Shannon, but this is the time of the year when the heart gets a little taxed.
Yeah, well, you know, I heard that the other day, Tom. I mean, there's a higher incidence of heart problems during the holidays with food, nutrition, stress, et cetera, et cetera. But women have different symptoms than men. That's what we're going to find out about.
All right, here's Dr. Warner and Shannon O'Kelly.
Dr. Cynthia Warner, welcome to Health Talk. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. You're a cardiologist. I want to kind of talk about your practice a little bit, working out of Providence in Everett and Mill Creek, right? So tell us about your locations, tell us about your clinic, and tell us about your practice.
Well, I've been practicing in the Western Washington area for about 12 years at Mill Creek and a Colby campus with Providence Medical Group. I'm a general cardiologist and subspecialize within diagnostics and cardiovascular imaging. And I see adult patients, both preventative, diagnostics, and in treatment therapies for all walks of cardiology.
Well, that's great, because we're going to talk about preventative diagnostics and treatment of cardiology, okay? That's exactly what the topic is today. So good choice, good timing, right?
Sounds good.
Yeah, so, but what I want to know is, you know, we hear about heart disease and heart attacks, cardiac arrest and all those neat things or not so neat things. We often kind of think about men. It's usually we're thinking about men. And we want to talk today about women and heart health, and some signs and symptoms are different than men. Progression is different, so let's set that stage, can we?
Sure. So it's important to get education and awareness out from a women's standpoint as well, too. Women are actually twice as likely more to die from heart attacks than men are.
I want to ask why. I mean, as you start to set this up, I'm going to ask you why, because I'm interested. That's an interesting fact.
Mm-hmm. It's very important. Mostly it's thought because women's symptoms can tend to be different than men, and the rate at which women report their symptoms tend to lag behind men as well, too.
Okay. So if a woman has a heart attack or a heart condition, they're more likely to die from it than men because of that fact you just shared with us. What else is going on?
Well, symptoms, let's talk about symptom-wise and how they differ. Everyone thinks about the quintessential severe, sudden onset of extreme chest discomfort. That's all what we all think about with quintessential heart attack. But heart disease in general and heart attack can be with many different symptoms that we call atypical symptoms. Not just in women, but more specifically in women, but for women and men as well, too. So other signs can be just a chest heaviness or a chest tightness, isolated jaw pain, shoulder pain, upper back pain. Some people have shortness of breath or just generalized weakness. And some people have absolutely no symptoms at all.
And I've heard that men, for example, a lot of times their most pronounced symptom of a heart attack is chest pain, almost pressure, and women have more arm and back pain. Is that true?
Correct.
So you have to follow those symptoms?
It's being aware of development of anything symptom-wise that is not your normal. So, like I said, for women, tends to be more kind of shoulder, back, jaw pain, not the quintessential heavy, severe chest pain.
And you don't always have to have, a lot of people think, well, I've got chest pain, but I don't have sweating or I don't have shortness of breath. They don't always have to go together or come in clumps. I mean, you can have a singular event and not have all three or two others.
Correct.
It's interesting.
All comers.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. But I mean, the reason I want to kind of hit this home is because so many people, I think the problem is they think, well, I've got indigestion or I've got a muscle spasm. I had a friend who is in his mid-50s and was working out in the yard and had like mid-back pain and just thought, oh, you know, I'm just working in the yard. He was having a heart attack. I mean, he was having symptoms. He ended up having
symptoms aside from what we just described, the variety of them. They don't always have to be a complete experience from everything we talked about. They can all be in isolation. They don't necessarily have to be sudden onset. They can be stuttering. They can be infrequent. They can start and stop. And so it's about being aware of the development of them.
More with Dr. Cynthia Warner and Shannon O'Kelly coming up after this time out on Como.
It's a Northwest Lifestyle Weekend on Como News. IRG's Health Talk continues.
Our conversation with Dr. Cynthia Warner on women's heart health continues with Shannon O'Kelly.
Dr. Cynthia Warner, thank you so much for joining us, cardiologist at Providence in Everett and Mill Creek. You're doing a great job setting up, the need to kind of be aware of heart attacks and heart problems in women. I'm wondering, as we're talking, is there certain points in a woman's life that maybe it peaks and there's more need to be aware of heart attacks?
Yeah, so being aware, specifically from a women's standpoint, you have to be aware of different parts of risk and disease treatment depending on what stage of life you're in. So for young women less than 40, the focus should be on prevention, okay? Mm-hmm. Living a healthy lifestyle. Okay. In middle-aged women from 40s to 60s, this is where risk for women now start to equal and then surpass men. This is when they go through menopause, which is, another risk factor for women in development of heart disease. And then for women in their older stages of lives, greater than 60, then this is about dealing with the disease and treatment of it. Older women tend to have more heart disease than their age-related counterparts in men.
I imagine that both men and women still share the same kind of risk factors. I mean, diet, lack of exercise, obesity, smoking, et cetera, all those key indicators that we need to watch.
So let's touch on risk factors.
Yeah.
So there's the ones that both women and men share, and that is optimizing your blood pressure, knowing your cholesterol, optimizing that as well too, optimizing do you have sugar or diabetes problems, what is your weight, are you obese, are you eating healthy, and are you sedentary or are you living an active life. Aside from that, there are risk factors that are more specific to women. I touched upon already the menopause. Mm-hmm. So when women go through menopause, now their risk starts to equal and then subsequently surpass men. There's also smoking, which we touched about a little bit as well too. But for women, it tends to be the single most preventable risk factor. Mm. So for women who smoke compared to women who don't smoke are at a threefold increase of developing heart disease.
Wow.
Now that is more than men. Men have a twofold increase. So women have increased risk from a smoking perspective. Aside from that, in general, the rates of smoking in our population over time recently have decreased, right? But for women, the decrease in the rate of smoking doesn't seem to be as prevalent. So they lag behind there as well, too. So smoking from a woman perspective, in reality, for all of cardiovascular disease, smoking is the single most preventable cause that you can stop doing to reduce your risk. But that risk seems to be accentuated in women.
And as we wrap up here, I mean, fantastic information. I just want to give kind of the cardinal rule. Don't sit around and wait or think it's going to go away if they have what?
So I think the most important thing for everybody, but including women, especially as symptoms are atypical, is knowing what your risk factors are, knowing those numbers, your blood pressure, your diabetes, your cholesterol, living a healthy life, like we talked about, stopping smoking. And anytime anything feels abnormal or unusual to you, then going in and discussing with your doctor and in the context of your risk factors, then forming a treatment plan.
There you go. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks for having me.
You've been listening to Dr. Cynthia Warner, cardiologist from Providence Medical Group, cardiology in Mill Creek, and Everett, talking about heart health for women. If you'd like to get more information, you can go to providence.org. Show starting to wind down. We have one more segment. We're going to come back and talk a little bit more as we get ready for the big day in just 3 days. We'll do that right after this time out on Como.